Hello and greetings from Iceland. We seem to be getting very close to the next eruption, according to the latest news from careful scientists. But my first volcano tour of 2025, it had to come to an end, at least for a few days, after 12 days in Reykjavík. But not totally useless though, since I had a little freelance job to finish in the city. And I did several trips into Grindavík, where I was filming the surroundings quite well, when the weather was good enough. But I had to return to the north 2 days ago to undergo a little surgery yesterday, or the second one since December to finish a little problem. And it looks as I will be recovering very fast from this one, so it won't be interrupting my work. Although I won't be doing any mountain climbing soon. Or this excellent excuse to make the drone do the hard work for me. And let's move on to what our scientists are saying now, because I can sometimes blame them for some of the unnecessary fuel burn, chasing events that didn't take place. But I can also blame myself, because I have my own system, of course, where I assume certain errors among experts. But this time I was just too early for this eruption number 11 that could have started days ago, technically speaking. And today we got the information that the magma level is now exactly where it was before the last eruption in November, or well above the lower threshold. And the tension in the crust has also decreased with each event, so we hardly get any earthquakes before eruptions start. And the best indicators are some of the geothermal boreholes that are monitored in the power plant. And during my stay, everything was very calm until the last day when I spent a few hours driving around, since the earthquake activity had picked up a bit, and it is still doing so. And this morning I was close to driving to Reykjavík again, but the visibility by the volcano was miserable, so even the closest webcams would have been useless. And the wind and the weather was actually a huge problem during my stay there. The Reykjanes Peninsula is a very windy place. And I have had moments there that my drones will never forgive me. But this time I tried to pick the best days, at least to capture footage that will be useful if I will be talking about the next eruption from home. So I have the before footage from all angles to show you where the lava is going and such. And we know that the lava berms, they can only hold so much. The first 24 hours will be critical. And the status now is that every day that you have to wait could mean a larger eruption than last time, as more magma accumulates every day. The inflow to the magma reservoir under Svartsengi has however been decreasing lately. And one of our volcanologists has been saying that this chapter might not even end up with a volcanic eruption, or Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson. He has never been afraid to swim against the mainstream and even tends to get things right going that way. But I am more in the mainstream myself as for this scenario, since we are getting so far into this magma inflation chapter. And it takes so little for the magma to erupt. This is all open for business. And after Mother Earth pulls the plug under there, it takes less than 30 minutes to see the product come out from the oven. And looking at this from the map, we have the town here. The green lines are the lava berms around the town and the power plant and the blue lagoon. If the eruption comes up to the north from here, all the lava will flow down to the power plant and the blue lagoon. But if the fire comes up a bit further south, it's all coming down to town. And although I'm in no position to come up with any scientific arguments, I'm still saying that I believe that the worst is over by the town. There would have to be some significant change in the plumbing system under there between eruptions if the lava will yet again try to break its way to the south instead of going this easy way to the north. And that is a place that I was focusing at with my drone. And it was the August eruption that gave us a new hope for the town, when the fissure opened up further to the northeast than ever before. The ancient Sundhnúkur fissure has erupted almost end to end already, and I was hoping that the last eruption would have occurred a bit further north. We have plenty of space there for lava, where it will do no harm, and it can actually do us some good there if it flows over the old military exercise field there and blows up some of the leftover ammunition there. But that has been a problem for years, old exercise field there. And as many of you remember, the last eruption returned further south again, not far enough to send lava to Grindavík, but it hit the lava berms from another angle this time, and faster as well, since those craters are getting higher and higher. And that's why the Blue Lagoon car park got under so fast. And while the lava was submerging the car park, the machines were working, trying to prevent overspill. And it would be no surprise if the next eruption will hit the same location from the same angle. It looks as the easiest way and the most logical way. So the lava berms, they have a new buffer zone there with this addition. But will it be enough? That is the big question. They are designed to handle a similar dose of lava as in November. But like I mentioned, every day we have to wait is not helping as for the lava quantity. So we want to get this over and done with sooner than later. But it's still plenty of room for surprises, like a new eruption location, for example in the mountain Varadalsfjall, where all this started, or in the so-called Eldvörp craters at the other side of Grindavík. And this series of events has proved to be unpredictable. Not even the most experienced experts in the world have been able to lay this out. But after all, we are going through a major volcanic tectonic event for the first time at this location since modern equipment came into being. So it's highly important to monitor this, collect data for the science community, but despite all the data that they will get now and in future, I'm not sure if they will ever be able to predict events like this fully. There will always be some level of uncertainty, despite all the equipment we have. And scientists have been extra careful now when it comes to statements. But to sum this up, the data is saying that we are getting very close to the next eruption. It might be the last one, at this location at least. And we are as ready as we can be. I'm leaving webcam links in the video description as usual. And I'm also adding a new link to the Met Office that has now a live streaming site on YouTube from a fiber optic monitoring instrument. And this is monitoring the full length of two cables along the Reykjanes Peninsula. And it has to be great news for geology nerds. And although this kind of footage is not keeping me busy, I think it's way better than many of the modern Hollywood movies we are getting now. So enjoy this new feature from Iceland, the Met Office. And as for me, I'm getting into my good old self, over and done with this little medical chapter I had to go through. And I'm going through a similar chapter with my good old Land Cruiser. It's the only twin turbo cruiser in the country now, but the new turbine is however still in the trunk. And the other one has a little hole in it. So I should have replaced it already, but I've been having those nightmares, waking up, seeing everything on fire on the webcams, and my car is in the repair shop, with some of my cameras as well. So I guess I will have to drive around with my spare parts a while longer, but while the car is working fine like it's doing, I'm fine with that. And I filled the tank with fuel today, I'm charging all batteries as well, emptying all memory cards after my last trip, and thinking things over. If the eruption starts in the middle of the night when I don't notice it, and when I wake up I see that I can't be at the eruption site until the biggest part of this show is over, it's not much that it will do for my film stock. But like I mentioned the other day, the footage that it needs is the part showing the so-called full curtains after the eruption starts, when the complete fissure is erupting. That is the part that I would prefer to get with the equipment I have now. And if that won't be possible, my channel might be more useful if I do a video from home, using the new footage that I was filming there the other day, showing you where the lava is going and what we are facing. And such coverage has actually always turned out well for the channel, rather than to be on the road while the heat is on. So it's a bit tricky to be over 4 hours away. Like it's also a bit tricky to stay away from my main workstation for weeks. And that is why I plan to move to the south as soon as I can. But that is a separate story to be told soon. But as for this eruption, that will start in the next days likely. I will cover it as well as I can. But if this will start during daytime, like with some earthquakes, some indications telling me to get moving, I might do so. Jump in the car and take my chance and try to report this on the way like I've done before. I might also take off after this upload, since when I was finishing my notes for this video, it was announced that SMS warnings will be sent to all near Grindavík today as the tension is rising. So the Civil Protection Agency is testing all systems now. Grindavík is open. There are around 50 houses occupied and perhaps a couple of hundred people working there during daytime in the fish industry. So the town and the Blue Lagoon and the whole area has to be evacuated when this starts. So growing tension is the way to describe this now. And I have the feeling that this video will be the last video before the action starts. And many thanks to you who have been supporting this work of mine. It is highly appreciated since this channel is still in the build-up stage and this year's task is to get it more stable than Icelandic volcanoes. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.